All right then, you're here, I'm Tom, let's write some code. Boop. Here we go. Now, I know why that hasn't picked up. Hopefully, there we go. So let's see what we... what we're going to work on today, shall we? Issues. So, we could add a background layer. Going to ignore these ones. We can continue our work to be letting the levels accessed by code. Or we can do the work for colour and reskinning items, or we can finish off the animation frames for the lemmings. Although this is probably going to be a fairly big one, and these two are going to be jointly fairly big, so let's start off by doing the level code and see where we get to from there. So, done this bit. So, we want to add an event listener for key presses. Game state should have a flag to see whether it's interested in collecting the text. And just realised my light is in completely the wrong position now. In fact, it's in very the wrong position. It's on completely the wrong side of the desk. Oh well, I'll fix that later. So, let's get that bit done. Fact. Const key press listener message equals, let's just keep it simple, shall we? Press listener. If e.data.instruction is equal to key press listener message, do something else, do something else. On key press E. So we are going to send it an instruction of key press, and then I know this has changed recently, well not recently, probably a long time ago, I haven't dealt with direct input for a long while, it's all frameworks these days. key down. Okay. So, e.code gives us this string value. So we've got dot code and dot key code. Key code is a number. And code is, I'm guessing, a enumerable or something like that. So let's see. Press to character. So, how long ago was this? 2017? Maybe 2009. String dot from car character code. That's what we need, I think. So we'll just send through the character for now. I wonder if there's a way to get just the what is it? Is there a way to get just the letters? Key down and key up provide a code indicating which key is pressed. Well, key presses what character was pressed. Okay. Don't know what IME composition is. Let's find out. Input method editor. Okay, so I don't think we need to worry about it so much. So let's change our search to I guess it's probably no, I think it's things like enter and symbols and all. We might need symbols. Yeah, let's shove everything through. And if there's any bugs from it, we can deal with them. Let's see if this works. And the reason I define that as a method instead of adding it as an event listener directly is going to only listen at certain times. Actually, let's tag this onto the document or even screen. Or click target. Let's do document for now. Probably rename this as well to key down. It's not on key down, it's just key down. So, if we should listen, we add listener, otherwise we remove the listener. So in here, we need a method which what do we call it? Call it foo for now. Wait, want it added to the index. Index or loop? I guess we can add it to the index and export it to anywhere that needs it. I wonder if I can pass booleans back straight off. I mean, a boolean is basically just an integer, right? critical, it should listen. Keep it consistent all the way through. So now we need to listen to the key down message. So now we've got two things. We're expecting the key down instruction fairly rarely and default to the mouse and the click. And what else? We need to just send it through. So now we just need a key down method and a key press listener. So in index, declare function key press listener. Yes, that's the work that we ran through it. Keep forgetting what we call this thing. Should listen. So we've got that. And then function key down character string. So we want a public method for, or public field for user enter text. And we want some methods. Do I add a text character and reset text? Easy enough. This one, let's do some regular expressions. I guess the right place for this would be in text. Allowed user input characters equals new regex. Okay, so let's do something a bit simpler than regular expressions. So we can have, that is 52, A to Z, capital or lowercase, numbers, and let's just take a look at the fact it's in the index, isn't it? So that seems to be all letters. I'm going to ignore that message. This seems to be all uppercase and lowercase letters, or basically all uppercase letters, so ...120 levels in all. So I wonder if it comes through as uppercase or lowercase by default. Let's move this out. Made you to uppercase or lowercase character based on what it defaults to and what whether the shift key is pressed. about the caps lock. I could just have used Whimpered all be uppercase in this. Might not be a bad idea since we can only actually render uppercase characters. But in text, I wanted to then do split it so that we've got an array. And here, did I export it? I did not. And we should probably put a space in there as well. We won't need it just yet, but it's good to have. So we've got this. We'll add that there, and yeah, we'll keep it as that. Now, what do we want to do? So we've done adding the listener, sending it through to WASM. We did this slightly the way around to make it more efficient. Have a button on the title screen to enter a level code that opens up a new meta level with a prompt to enter text. When the meta level is constructed, it sets the collect text flag, and when it renders, it displays whatever is in the game state text field. So we want this this new meta level in the constructor to call keyPressListener true. There should be a clear button, a back button, and a go button in the level. If the code is correct, then load the level, otherwise show a try again message before leaving the meta level. Set the collect text flag to false and clear the text that has been input. So, all fairly easy. Add ability for user to input text into the WASM engine. So let's take a look at total screen. Level code entry .ts. Since meta screen, So, instantly UI controls. We want... what buttons did we say? Clear, back, and go. Panel position will be dead center, and we won't put any items there directly. So this needs to be this dot action panel dot items dot push. So it's going to be let's see if we can find a view of what it actually looks like. So we've got one player, new level, music, fun. Don't see anything here that tells us what the level code entry screen looked like. I need to go play the game again. My memory is so bad on some of it. Okay, we will just wing it. So, this will be... my brain is not thinking of, like, naming things is particularly hard for me today. So, let's have, back, clear, and then go. So we'll have a private method. We'll have a private const here because delegates can't refer to this, I don't think. It can't refer to the class. Before leaving. So it says wrong file. Yeah. So, disable the flag and clear the text that has been input. So, before we do the back button, we do the do before leaving method, or constant, or function, or whatever you wish to call it, and then level is a new title screen, and we are going to load it. And then we're going to push clear in the middle. Which is going to be much more simple. Just going to reset the text and a go button. We will get the level code from the whatever the user entered text is. Oh yeah, what I should do is reset the text as soon as this is loaded. Taxing and mayhem. Wonder if I can do it like this. So I cannot we're just going to loop through the difficulties, and for each one level we are going to have a level which will start off as null, and if level difficulty codes. So if the level code exists at this difficulty level, level factory equals we'll get the level factory from the difficulty. We will assign the level and we will break outside of it if level does not equal null. Low fat, we can do this easily enough. Do before leaving load level, else display message to user. So we kind of want to override the render of this, I think. Or maybe not override it, maybe we just want to intercept it. So let's take a look at the end slate. The meta screen. Hello, if you've just joined us, we are currently trying to get text input into our Lemmings game, because at the moment we've got buttons like the start button, we've got all the skills in place, but we don't have a way of the user to enter the actual level codes. So here we've got render level, which is fine, but what we want to do is just override this do want to call it eventually, but before we do, we want to get UI by tag. And we haven't added this UI yet, but we can do that in a second. The tag is going to be level code. Actually, we don't need to get it. I think we added something. Update label. That's better. And game state dot user entered text. So as the user enters text, we store it in the game state, and we're going to update the label each time it renders to show that off. So We will reset the text if it's wrong. In fact, what we can do is const code equals game state dot user entered text, and then update label level code message. Actually, we won't reset the text there. But what we'll do is we'll update that to be code is incorrect. Then clear, we can update the label. To be blank again. So now we just need to add them. So number one is going to be level code message. And number two is going to be the level code itself. So both of these want x to be minus one and y to be just say this should be 15 and this should be 20, and we'll see how that goes. So I think that's the basics. I'm not going to bother with backspace for now. They can just clear it and start entering it again, but I might do that later. So on our title screen, we want the start button to be in a UI panel. Action panel dot items, and start and code. Level is going to be level code entry. And we're going to load it. So let's see what we've got. We did this bit. Button on the title screen we just did. When this meta level is constructed, it sets the collect text flag, and when it renders, it displays whatever the game state text field. Yep. In fact, did I actually set that it should collect the text? No. Glad I spotted that one. Thank you, Pastel, for making very explicit feature comments. Clear, back and go. And yep, I think we've got all of that. Bring up the browser console just so that it refreshes correctly. It does not like quite a bit of what we just did. Oh, for God's sake. We're back here again. Okay, so I think this one is stopping the game state from compiling, and the other ones might have just come in from that. I hope. Well, it got rid of some of them. Let's deal with this the same way we dealt with everything else for now. Game state, I've probably got some stuff I don't need anymore. And here, I need to change the imports. Okay, so we have most of the problems sorted. Here we can't use. So we've got 29 and 48, so that's 29, and that's 48. I even said it, didn't I? We can't use this inside the delegates. We can't do it like this because I can't have external variables in the delegates. Gonna try anyway, but it's gonna fail. Not implemented closures. Okay, we will hack around it. The level is an instance of level code entry. Actually, we don't need that, do we? Level dot update label tag text. And we will make that public. Can't complain about that. Can fail to compile because of game state being missing, but can't complain about update level, update label. Well, now nothing's on the start button. Okay, so I did not push the panel into the panel place. We will do the same. Start or code? That doesn't look central to me, but I think it's just because I'm at an angle. Yeah, it's pretty much central. So, start still works. Buttons here still work. Back, clear, go. In our index file,
unlock the character. And in here, we will log prop character. Character. That should help us lower down anywhere it's not quite hooked up properly. So something is undefined. Gonna assume E dot should listen is undefined, which means here keep this listener. So in our index, let's change this to an I32. Let's just do I8. See what happens. And in here, should listen equals 1. Code undefined still. E dot data. You know, I had a feeling I missed out a dot data somewhere, and I didn't know what it was. And that's odd, it doesn't pull me up on the fact that I was sending the wrong thing through. Okay, so here, we'll put this back to a boolean. Code. True listening. A memory access out of bounds in so key down we didn't even get the got character. Yeah, it's. I don't think we've ever passed a string through before. There is a special way of doing it, which is. I can check it if this doesn't work. Need to compile with export runtime. So, I guess here.
Hey. Okay, we can remove all of those logs, but let's do... So we get the click event, we get into the delegate. Levels, base level, get. Okay, so does it... Does the has thing not work? Or did I just code it wrong? Clear some of these logs. And that shouldn't have worked at all. Seems to be okay. The label starts off centered. Might need to change the label to be -1, -1. Okay, title screen, base level, that's fine. Fix missing sub-object. Assembly. Create meta screen or level code entry. Okay, so here, render level.
So since we have the label here, we will update its text there, and then label dot get position dot x equals minus one. I'm hoping it's cloned, that's not going to do anything. Label dot set position. New vec2 minus one label dot get position dot y, and force center of label to be recalculated. So it seems like dot has isn't quite working properly. Levels for difficulty equals this. Const level code correct for level code correct for difficulty equals levels for difficulty dot has level code. If level code correct for difficulty is true, level factory equals levels for difficulty dot get level code. So we'll log the difficulty level and the whether it's correct for the difficulty. So, code. So that's properly centering itself now. Go. Has level zero, false.
So it doesn't log selecting level. It logs has level. So 105.17. Index.ts does not have a line 105. So let's take a look at this. Level code entry, constructor of anonymous. Map. I'm guessing that's the level difficulty codes. Dot get. Is it doing like speculative execution or something? Because it doesn't log the message. Let's try recompiling and doing a hard refresh. No, it's definitely not logging anything. Yeah, this is the same message. So this bit seems okay because I get this log message and maybe. Okay, so what if I comment out these two lines? Still doesn't like it. So what if I map, if I comment out these two lines?
code is incorrect. Has level 0, 1, 2, 3. Okay, so it's this one that it doesn't like. So, if I uncomment just that line, it'll either crash or it won't have compiled it because it's not used. It crashes. Well, that's at least something we can test against. Doing it. Loop processing inputs. Okay. Still crashes. Unreachable, which means it thinks that the thing I'm passing in isn't something it will ever need to process. Yeah, so it's not handling the difference between the enum and the i32 properly. Let me just quickly put a new issue so that I remember to at some point look into it deeper. Cannot be used in maps. As a key, it will only allow access to each element if the enum is passed into the get or has method. So assigning the enum to... Let's try this minute. Difficulty... Difficulty equals difficulties I. See whether that crashes or not. Just test my assumption. Yeah, it still crashes. Assigning the enum to any intermediate variable loses its type when it's compiled, and an unreachable and the program aborts with an unreachable error. Right, got that listed there. So it's not too bad because we can do it slightly differently. So, I equals 0, I is... I wonder... No, that doesn't have an iterator. These are just string now. Shouldn't compile. Type expected. Okay, so it doesn't like that at all. Let's just do this. So this is an array of level codes. I wonder if that just gets every single thing. And level codes is a map string level factory, so this might actually be better. I'm guessing there's going to be four elements in foo. If foo I dot has level code level equals foo I dot get level code. This needs to be const level factory. Level equals level factory break. And let's get rid of all of this. There we go. Okay, so I had to jump through some hoops, but this is actually a lot simpler. Okay, that's good. So AAA is incorrect. Now, reload the level. I did not think it was going to take that long to sort that out. It looks like there's some odd artifacting. Let's look at the actual stream. It's not too bad. What's the bit rate here? 2400, that should be fine. But yeah, allow levels to be accessed by level code. I think we can call that a success. Now, let's have a look at everything that's left. There is adding background layers, I'm not going to bother with that right now. Color to ground tiles, reskinned brick tile, definitely way too big for this part of the stream. Finish off lemming action animation frames, that's big, and this needs to be tagged with compiler error, really. So I think I'm just going to finish it up slightly early, and let's commit this code. So here, stage this. This is just make sure level code text is centered. And this is the big one, which is fix level code checks. Done. So, I would just like to thank everyone very much for watching. I am... I'm going to end the stream here. If you want to follow more, there's a Discord link in my channel. Channel description, profile header thing. But wherever you are, whatever you do next, have a very nice day.